My name is Кирилл Гручников. I've been at Google for the last 5 years, and I do client work, UI work on the Play Store.
Okay, awesome. And what do you like about it?
Well, I always liked writing code and seeing pixels light up on the screen. So this is the Play app, Google Play app. Starting from top to bottom, we have the search box, and we have this what we call quick links to go to various subsections of the app and of the store. And then we have different content here. So we have clusters of cards. We have this we call a banner that gets you into some other place in the app. You can go into the details page of a certain item, let's say Angry Birds Tallapop. And this is what we're showing here, kind of the mix of information that developer has provided. We have the video of the app. Then we have the short description of the app, screenshots. Then we have the user provided content, reviews and ratings of that app, a little bit more related content. And then here a couple of links. And you can go and also from the details page, you can start the install process. This is the permissions. And then you go and accept them. And it starts, you can see over here, it starts installing it.
So the students have been learning about text views, image views, buttons. Can you point out a couple of those in the app?
Yeah, so back to the cards. If we look at this Star Wars Rebels, so the card itself is an extension of a view group, but it can be as simple as an extension of a relative layout. And then we have this thumbnail is an image view. Then we have this Star Wars Rebel is a text view that goes to maximum of 2 lines. Rating bar is, well, rating bar. The free is a text view, and the overflow dots is an image view with a source set to a certain PNG that looks like 3 dots. And then the same for the quick links. So it is a relative layout with the image view on the left, and then the text view in single line mode going to right of that image view and extending however much it needs. And it has its background set to a certain drawable that has a green background with rounded corners. So essentially, as you say, it boils down to taking these very basic building blocks, text views, image views, sometimes rating bar, progress bar, spinner, checkbox, radio button, and combining them based on what your design shows on a particular screen.
Yeah, that's so cool because the students are learning this in the very first lesson of Android, and you're using this every day in the Google Play app. You mentioned working with a designer, so can you describe what that process is like?
So it starts from the product people, and then it goes into discussions with design and engineering on what are the screens that we are talking about, and how hopefully already at that point on the design side we start thinking about how it adapts to smaller screens, to larger screens. After that, we do this kind of iterations on putting something on the screen and start validating the overall approach, because sometimes you have a static mock or maybe a motion mock from, like, you know, After Effects or whatever tools the designers are using, and you see it on your desktop screen, and then you put it on the phone and it feels quite different because you have a smaller screen, or because it's a touch interaction, or maybe because, you know, you are depending on all these great big images, but the network is slow, and so you start with a screen that 5 seconds doesn't display anything. And so hopefully throughout this iterative process where we put something on the screen, not necessarily pixel perfect, then we can go back into the product level discussions and see, okay, what do we need to tweak?
So for developers who don't have a designer to work with, do you have suggestions on what they can do to make their app look better?
I would suggest going to the website for material design and get acquainted, not necessarily like, you know, with the finer parts of like, you know, motion arcs or all those interpolators, but focus on the bigger picture. So to have consistent grid across the entire app, what we call key lines, or what the design calls key lines, vertical and horizontal, where elements align to certain visual rhythm, and they don't feel just randomly thrown onto the screen. And so you have your toolbar, you have maybe your maybe like other parts of your Chrome, like the navigation elements in your screen, and then you have the content itself. So it's great when it all aligns to the same grid, and you have a little bit of margins on the sides, and you know, things are not too close to each other. Then you have a typography, which is a great way to visually convey the relative importance of different things. So if you talk about something like inbox or like Gmail or like an email app, so if everything has the same typographical language, if everything is the same color, the same size, and the same style, then it's not really easy to scan it. So maybe you would want there to make the sender a little bit bigger, like the sender name, or maybe the title, or like the first few words of the subject to be bold. And that would allow the user to more quickly scan. Depends once again on your content. But I wouldn't recommend necessarily going with too many styles or too many sizes. 3-4 styles used consistently across multiple screens allow the user to kind of get, even on a subconscious level, to get kind of a picture of how to get things done in your app and not necessarily fight to understand where the information is that he or she is looking for. And the last thing, colors. Use a little bit of, especially with material, it kind of leans toward using big splashes of saturated colors, which looks great, especially if it goes into the status bar on Lollipop devices. Identify maybe, like, you know, what we call them, accent colors and primary colors. Identify a couple colors and use them to kind of like, you know, to style the Chrome of your app. So like status bar, action bar, maybe a little bit in the drawer, in the navigation drawer. And use highlights or accents for the floating action button, or maybe for like, you know, to draw attention to a certain like very important element, what you consider an important element. And I think these three go a long way towards, like, you know, emphasizing a little bit more, like, you know, the visual style of the app. And of course, if you have an opportunity to team up with the designer, that's always great.